en welkom to part 2 of the Oasis Mandala. In part 2 we make round 17 up to round 32. Let's get started! Make a slip knot on the hook with a new color. The place where we start is above a cluster, in the first double crochet in a group of 2. And that's the place where we start with a standing double crochet. Then we make a V-stitch and chain 2. And back into that same stitch with another double crochet. This is the first V-stitch. Now make a chain 1 and then we skip the next 3 stitches and then into the next stitch we make a new V-stitch, a double crochet in that stitch, then a chain 2 and back into that same stitch with another double crochet and then a chain 1. And this is the repeat we work all the way around. Now we skip the next 3 stitches and then into the next stitch a new V-stitch, 1 double crochet, chain 2 and 1 double crochet into that same stitch and then a chain. Skip the next 3 stitches and double crochet into the next stitch, chain 2, double crochet in that same stitch and a chain 1. Work so all the way around and then in the beginning we make an invisible join, not on that first standing double crochet but on the second stitch, and that's that first chain stitch. We start with a new color. We start in a V-stitch above a cluster with a standing 3 double crochet together. The yarn is on the hook, yarn over, enter your hook in that V-stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2. Yarn over, back into that same V-stitch, grab your yarn, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over, back into that same V-stitch, grab your yarn, yarn over, pull for 2. Now you have 4 loops on the hook, yarn over, pull for all the loops on the hook. Make a chain 3, 1, 2 and 3. Now back in that same V-stitch, we work another 3 double crochet together. That's 1, 2 and 3, yarn over, pull through all the loops. Make a chain 3, 1, 2 and 3. Now we skip over to the next V-stitch and into that V-stitch we make another group of 3 double crochet together, chain 3, 3 double crochet together. That's 1, 2 and 3 double crochet and work together. Make a chain 3 and a 3 double crochet together in that same V-stitch. That's 1, 2, 3, yarn over, pull through all the loops and then make a chain 3. We skip over to the next V-stitch. In that V-stitch we work again 3 double crochet together. Chain 3, and 3 double crochet together in that same V stitch. And a chain 3. And this is the repeat. You work all the way around. In the beginning, we make an invisible join. Not in the first stitch, but on the second stitch. We start with a new color. We start between the two clusters of 3 double crochet together in that chain 3 space with a standing double crochet. In that same space we make 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. Now we skip the next cluster and in the next chain 3 space we work 2 double crochets in that space. That's 1 and 2. Skip the next cluster and between the next 2, 3 double crochets clusters in that chain 3 space we work 4 double crochets. That's 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now in the next chain 3 space, 2 double crochets in that space, 1 and 2. And this is the repeat, we work all the way around. Into the next chain 3 space between the two clusters, 4 double crochets in that space. And into the next chain 3 space, 2 double crochets. Work so all the way around and in the beginning we make an invisible join, always on the second stitch. Make a slip knot on the hook. We begin with a standing single crochet. On the first double crochet of the group of 4 double crochets. Then make a chain 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now we skip the next 5 stitches, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then into the next stitch, make a single crochet. Make a chain 5. We skip the next 5 stitches, and then into the next stitch, a single crochet. This is the repeat, we work all the way around. Always a single crochet, we work on a group of 4 double crochets in that first double crochet. Make a chain 5. Skip 5 stitches. And then into the next stitch, a single crochet. So on the top of that first double crochet of that group of 4. Work so all the way around your stitches and then we make an invisible join on the second stitch. And we start with a new color on the hook. The place where we start is in a chain 5, above a cluster here. In that space we begin with a standing double crochet. Another double crochet into that same chain 5 space. Now we work a front post double crochet. Here's a group of 4 double crochets and this is a group of 2 double crochets. And around the first double crochet of that group of 2, we make that front post double crochet. Yarn over. Go around that first double crochet of the group of 2, front to the back, from the back to the front, fold your work to the back, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. Now back in that same chain 5 space, we make 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. Repeat this 2 more times. Into the next chain 5 space, 2 double crochets. Then we make a front post double crochet around 19. This is the group of 4, this is the group of 2, and then around that first double crochet of the group of 2. A front post double crochet, back to the chain 5 space, and there we make 3 double crochets. It's 1, 2, and 3. Repeat one more into the next chain 5 space, 2 double crochets. Then a front post double crochet in round 19, the group of 2 around the first double crochet. Back to the chain 5 space and make 3 double crochets in that same space. That's 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, and 3, the same repeats. Into the next chain 5 space we make 1 double crochet more. 3 double crochets in that chain 5 space. It's 1, 2, and 3. Then work around the first double crochet of the group of 2 and front post double crochet. And then back in that same chain 5 space with another 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. All these stitches we work all the way around. Make a repeat of 3 more times, a 2 double crochet, front post double crochet, 3 double crochets, that's 1, 2, and 3, and then you work 3 double crochets, front post double crochet, 3 double crochets into that same space. That's the way you work all the way around, and in the beginning you make an invisible join, always on the second stitch. We start with a new color. And we start in a group of 3 double crochets, front post double crochet and 3 double crochets in the first double crochet of the group of 3. That's the point where we start with a standing single crochet. Into the next 9 stitches, a single crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Now we make a front post 7 double crochet in round 17. And this is the place here between the 2 clusters. In that chain 1 space. Yarn over the hook 7 times. 7. Go to round 17. Go around that stitch. Fold your work to the back. Yarn over, pull up. Yarn over, pull for 2. 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 And once more, yarn over, pull for 2. Till we have 1 stitch left over on the hook. Now we do not skip a stitch on the back. We go straight to the next stitch and make a single crochet. And that's the first of 25 single crochets in total. That's 1. Go to the next stitch. 2. Into the next. 3. 4. 5. And the last stitch, number 25. And that stitch must be on the top of that front post double crochet of the previous round. Now you work a front post 7 double crochet around round 17. This stitch here. Yarn 7 times over the hook. And then work all the way back till you have 1 stitch over left on the hook. And then make in the next 25 stitches a single crochet. This is the repeat you work all the way around. I made my last front post 7 double crochet. We do not skip a stitch on the back. And now we have 15 stitches left over. It must be 25 in total. In the beginning we work already 10 single crochets. That's 25 single crochets in total. And my last stitch. I'm cut the yarn, pull all the way up, and then we make an invisible join. Not in the first stitch, that's that standing single crochet, but in the second. we start with a new color on the hook, and the point where we start is after a front post 7 double crochet, count 16 stitches. We start in that stitch with a standing single crochet with a new color. Now we work all the way around in every stitch one single crochet. Make all your stitches all the way around, and then in the beginning we close this round with a slip stitch on the top of that first standing single crochet. I make my last stitches of this round, and then we close with a slip stitch on the first standing single crochet. Don't cut the yarn. In the next round we use the same color, and now we have 208 stitches in total. With the same color we make a chain 1 and back into that same stitch a single crochet. Into the next 6 stitches also one single crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now we make a front post 3 double crochet around the front post 7 double crochet. Yarn 3 times over the hook. 1, 2, 3. Go around that front post 7 double crochet, grab your yarn and pull through, yarn over, pulled for 2, yarn over, pulled for 2, yarn over, pulled for 2, and yarn over, pulled for 2. Skip one stitch on the back. That's the stitch where we're working in. We skip one stitch. And then into the next stitch, one single crochet. And front post 3 double crochet around that same front post 7 double crochet. Go around that stitch. Grab your yarn and pull through. And work all the way back till you have one stitch left over on the hook. Now we do not skip a stitch on the back. Into the next stitch you make a single crochet and also a single crochet into the next stitch. For a third time we make a front post 3 double crochet around that front post 7 double crochet. And work all the way back till you have one stitch over on the hook. Now we skip the next stitch on the back. And then into the next stitch we make a single crochet. And that's the first of 21 single crochets. Into the next 20 stitches also a single crochet. This is number 2. 3, 4. 21 single crochets. Now we work this group here. 3 times and front post 3 double crochet together. Three times over the hook, go around that front post 7 double crochet and work all the way back. Skip 1 stitch and then into the next stitch 1 single crochet and front post 3 double crochet. Do not skip a stitch on the back, into the next 2 stitches 1 single crochet. And front post 3 double crochet. Then we skip the next stitch here on the back. And then in the next 21 stitches 1 single crochet. Repeat all these stitches all the way around and then in the beginning we make a slip stitch on the first single crochet. We skip the next stitch. And then in the next 14 stitches, we work 1 single crochet. In the beginning of this round, we work already 7 single crochets, that's 21 in total. The last stitch and now we close with a slip stitch on the top of that first single crochet. In the next round we use the same color and also a second color. In round 25 we work with 2 colors, color number 83, but we start with color number 85. Make a chain 1, then into the same stitch 1 single crochet and also a single crochet into the next 6 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, but number 6 we change from color. 2 loops on the hook and we make this single crochet complete with the second color, yarn over, pull through. Place color 85 on the back of your work. On the stitch of the front post 3 double crochet together, we make a cluster of 5 double crochets together. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 not complete double crochets. Yarn over and work all these stitches together. Change from color and we make this cluster complete with a chain. Into the next 2 stitches we make a single crochet and work around that other color on the back. That's 1. Into the next stitch, also a single crochet. That's two. Make a front post double crochet around that front post 3 double crochet. And then into the next two stitches, one single crochet. That's one. And the second, we work complete with the other color. Change from color. And work that single crochet complete. We make a cluster of 5 double crochets together on the top of that front post 3 double crochet. Work around that green color. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 6 loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through all the loops. And now we change from color to the green color and make a chain. Into the next 21 stitches, we work with the green color, one single crochet, and we work also around that second color here on the back, work around that thread. Into the next 21 stitches, one single crochet. You see that I'm working around that other color. The next stitch is stitch 21 and we change from color. Make that single complete with the second color. We make a cluster of 5 double crochets together. Into the next stitch, on the top of that front post 3 double crochet together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 doubles and we're complete. Change from color and then make a chain. Into the next 2 stitches, make a single crochet. That's 1 and 2. Now a front post double crochet. Into the next 2 stitches, 1 single crochet. And the second, we change from color. We make a cluster of 5 double crochets together on the top of that front post 3 double crochet. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Yarn over, work together and change from color. Then with the green color, we make in the next 21 stitches, one single crochet and work around that second color. Work so all the way around and in the beginning, we make an invisible join. This is my last cluster here and now in the next 15 stitches, you make one single crochet. It must be 21 in the beginning. You work already 6 single crochets. That's 21 in total. Now we cut both yarn and open up that last stitch, pull the hook all the way up, and then in the beginning we make an invisible join. This is the chain one. We skip that stitch, also that first stitch. We go to the second single crochet of this round, back to the last stitch. Work both threads in on the back of your work. New colors on the hook, and we begin with a standing double crochet on the top of the first cluster. Through the stitch here, yarn is on the hook, yarn over, on the through that stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for two, yarn over, pull for two. In the next three stitches, we make a double crochet. It's one, two, and three. That's on the top of that front post double crochet here. We make a front post double crochet around that front post double crochet of the previous round. Into the next three stitches we make a double crochet. The first stitch is here on the back, then in the next and on the top of the cluster. One. Two, then on the top of the cluster. In the next 21 stitches, a double crochet, and that brings us to the next cluster stitch here. That's one, two, three. And 21. On the cluster, also a double crochet. Now skip here that chain stitch and then into the next three stitches, one double crochet. It's one, two, and 3. A front post double crochet around that front post double crochet of the previous round. Then into the next 2 stitches and on the top of the cluster also a double crochet. That's 1 and 2 on the top of the cluster. Then skip here that chain stitch and work in the next 21 stitches and double crochet. That's the repeat you work all the way around. To close this round, we make an invisible join, not in the first standing double crochet, but in the second. We have now 232 double crochets in total. In round 27, we work with 2 colors, color 87, but we start with color 80. We make a slip knot on the hook and we begin with a standing single crochet, 11 stitches for that front post double crochet here. Count 11 stitches back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. In that stitch, that's the point where we start with a standing single crochet. Then in the next 10 stitches, also a single crochet. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. But we make this stitch not complete with color 80. We change from color to work that single crochet number 10 complete. I make a little knot on the back. Secure that new color. We go further with the pink color. We make on the top of that front post double crochet a cluster of 5 double crochets together. And we place that green color here on the back of our work and we work around that second color. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 not complete double crochets. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. Change from color and make a chain. Another chain stitch and then in the next 28 stitches 1 single crochet and we work also around that pink color. That's 1, 2, 3, 26, 27 and 28. But stitch 28 must be working complete with another color. Change from color and pull through two loops to work that last single crochet complete. On the top of that front post double crochet, we make another cluster of 5 double crochets together. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Yarn over, pull through, change from color, make a chain 2. That's 1 and 2. And then in the next 28 stitches, a single crochet. And we work also around that pink color here on the back. That's the repeat you work all the way around. After the last cluster of 5 double crochets together, you need to work 17 single crochets. And you make an invisible join here in the beginning. We start with a new color on the hook. We start in a stitch. Doesn't matter which one. You start in a stitch with a standing single crochet. And now all the way around you make in every stitch one single crochet. For that cluster, also a single crochet. On the top of that cluster, also a single crochet. And a single crochet in that chain 2 space after the cluster. And then in every stitch, a single crochet. Work all the way around in every stitch a single crochet, and then we close on the top of that first standing single crochet with a slip stitch. In the next round we use the same color. Our mandala counts now 240 single crochets in total. With the same color, we make a chain 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The first 3 chain stitches are a double crochet and then a chain 2. Into that same stitch, we make a double crochet. And this is our first V-stitch. Make a chain one. Now skip the next three stitches and then into the next stitch we make a new V-stitch. A double crochet, chain two, and a double crochet into that same stitch. And that's the repeat we work all the way around. After that V-stitch we make a chain one, skip the next three stitches, and then into the next stitch a V-stitch, a double crochet, chain two, and a double crochet into that same stitch. And chain one, skip the next three stitches, into the next stitch and double crochet, chain two, and a double crochet for a next V stitch, and then a chain. Work so all the way around, and then in the beginning we close this round with an invisible join. I work my last V stitch here, then we have to make a chain, and we skip the last three stitches. We make an invisible join, cut the yarn, open up that stitch. We skip always the first stitch, that's the first double crochet of the V stitch, and that's the chain three here in the beginning. One, two, three. We skip that stitch and we go to the next chain stitch, that's number four under through that chain stitch, and then back to the last stitch, that's the chain stitch after the last V stitch, only in a back loop. We start with a new color and we make a cluster of three double crochets together in a V-stitch. Yarn is on the hook, yarn over, enter your hook in a V-stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, back in that same V-stitch, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, into that same V-stitch, grab your yarn, yarn over, pull through two. Now you have four loops on the hook, yarn over and pull through all the loops. Make a chain two, one and two, and go back into that same V-stitch with another group of three double crochets together. That's one, two, and three, yarn over, pull through all the loops. And chain two, one and two, and now we skip over to the next V stitch. And we work again a cluster of three double crochet together. That's one, two, and three, yarn over, pull through all the loops. Then make a chain two and back into that same V stitch with a cluster of three double crochets together. And a chain two. And this is the repeat we work all the way around. Into the next V stitch. Three double crochets together, chain two, three double crochets together into that same V stitch, and chain two. Work so all your stitches all the way around, and then we close with an invisible join here in the beginning, not on the first stitch, that's that cluster of the three double crochets, but in the first chain stitch of the two. This stitch here. You make with the new color a slip knot on the hook. And we make a standing single crochet on the top of the second cluster of three double crochets together. Into that same stitch we make another single crochet. Then in the next 29 stitches a single crochet. It's in the space of the chain 2, on the top of the cluster, in the space of a chain 2, on the top of a cluster, then in the space, in the cluster, 29 single crochets in total. Then into the next stitch, we work two single crochets in that same stitch, one and two. Into the next 29 stitches, a single crochet. And then into the next stitch, two single crochets in that same stitch. Work so all the way around, and this round we close with a slip stitch on the top of that first standing single crochet. I worked all my stitches. Now on the top of that first standing single crochet, you work a slip stitch. In the next round, we use the same color. Start with a chain. And now we work all the way around every single crochet and back post single crochet. Work from the back to the front, the front to the back, and on the back of that stitch you make that single crochet. Around the next stitch and back post single crochet. Around the next stitch, in total you work 248 back post single crochets. On the end of this round we make an invisible join. We skip that chain stitch here. And also that first back post single crochet, we go to the second. That's the place where we make that invisible join. I worked all my stitches all the way around. I cut the yarn and I make an invisible join. We skip that chain stitch. And we skip that first back post single crochet. We go to the next stitch. From the front to the back. Pull through, back to the last stitch, and then only in the back loop. And then we weave the tail in on the back of the stitches. This is your invisible join. I make a little knot on the back. And weave both tails in, only in the back of the stitches. And this is the end of part 2. And you see that your mandala is not flat. I place some towels on my table. And put on top my mandala. I have some pins. And a plant sprayer with water. Work the mandala flat with your hands and place some pins in. Let the mandala dry before you remove the pins. My mandala is dry, I remove the pins and he is nice flat. This is the end of part 2, I hope to see you in part 3. Don't forget to subscribe if you're new here and give me a thumbs up below my videos. Click on the bell so you don't miss any new videos from me. You can find me also on Facebook and Instagram and my website biancascrochetpalace.com. Here's a suggestion for another video from me, I hope you like it. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye!